Hi everybody, welcome to today's BBC Learning English live English class. We've had lots of comments already saying hello, and I'll speak to you all in just a moment. But welcome to today's class, where we will be talking all about adjectives today. So we're going to be talking about gradable and ungradable adjectives, what they are, how we use them, and most importantly, how we modify them. Okay, so we'll get into that in just a few moments. First, let's say hello to some of our viewers. So we have Ava. Hello, Ava. Where are you watching from? And we also have Gayan, who is watching from Sri Lanka. Hi, thanks for joining us, Gayan. And we also have Taisia. I hope I'm saying that correctly. Apologies if I'm not. Nice to meet you. And we have, oh, everything's moving so quick. Hello, Jacqueline, who is watching from, oh, my knowledge of flags is not very good. Where are you watching from, Jacqueline? And we have Fatima as well saying hello. Hello to you too. And good evening from Cambodia as well. Oh, so moving so quickly, I can't click off the comments. So one more hello to Natalia. There we go. Excellent. So we're going to be talking about adjectives today and how we can modify different types of adjectives. So while you're all still saying hello, I will show you today's first question. So take a look at this. Take a jacket. It's a bit today. So how do we complete this sentence? Do we use A, cold, or do we use B, freezing? What do you think? Let us know in the comments, and we'll talk about what the correct answer is and why in just a few moments. Welcome if you're just joining us. Today's BBC Learning English live English class is all about adjectives. So we're going to talk about gradable and ungradable adjectives and how we can modify them. So remember to like the video and share it with your friends and invite them to come and join us and learn some English together. Okay, let's have a look at some of your answers. So we have Noel, who is saying cold, and Nusrat, who agrees and says that it's cold. We also have Kofi, who says cold as well. And we have a hello from Marcus in Brazil. And Lafba says it's cold too. And one more, Yar says cold. And Abdus says freezing. So a variety of answers. And the answers are moving so quick, I can't click off them. Excellent. Thank you all for your answers. I'll try and feature as many of you as I can during the class. But for now, let's take a look at the answer to this question. So take a jacket. It's a bit cold today. So why is cold the correct answer for this question? So cold and freezing have very similar meanings, but why is cold correct and freezing is incorrect? Can any of you tell me why cold is the correct answer? Let's see. Ooh, a few more hellos. Hello from Ali, who's watching in Syria. Hello, Ali. Nice to meet you. And we have Hafu saying, it's a bit cold today. Well done. Okay, but how about the answer? Why is cold the correct answer? So we've got one idea here. Cold is an adjective, freezing is a noun. Not quite, Sharia. Sorry if I'm pronouncing that incorrectly. They are both adjectives. They're just different types of adjectives. And that's the key to why we use cold here, but not freezing. Here we go. Let's use Winnie's answer. So Winnie says, because we are using a bit. You are absolutely 100% correct, Winnie. Well done. So we have to use cold in this sentence, and it's all because of the modifier a bit. So what we're looking at here are gradable adjectives. So cold is a gradable adjective. And what that means is that it can be modified. These are adjectives that have different levels or different degrees. So cold is one example that we've just seen. And there's also a few more here. Let's make that slightly bigger so you can read it. So good, bad, happy, and sad are all gradable adjectives. There's different levels to how good something is, or how bad something is, or how happy you are, or how sad you are. And we show the different levels or the different degrees by using modifiers. And that's what we're going to look at first, how to modify gradable adjectives. So have a look at this picture here. So on the right-hand side of your screen, you can see we have a thermometer. And next to it, we have options 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Number 3 is completed for you. It's just right in the middle. It's cold. But then we have this box of other modifiers. And what I want to know is, where do we put a bit, extremely, very, and quite on the thermometer? So see if you can match 1, 2, 4, and 5 with the different options. And we'll go through the answers very shortly. Just a few more hellos. Hello, Juvelin, who's watching from the Philippines. I hope I said your name correctly. Apologies if not. We also have Long, who is watching from Malaysia. Excellent. We have a very, very international audience today. I like it. Okay, let's see. Oh, I should have said, looking at those options, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, number 1 is going to be the least cold, and number 5 is going to be the most cold. So just think about that carefully when you're putting these modifiers into the correct spot. You want the one that means very, 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 very cold at number 5, and the one that means like the least cold at number 1, okay? So let's see what everybody thinks. So Ava says that we start with number 1 as a bit, and Benita says 1 a bit, 2 quite, 4 very, and 5 extremely. And, that's a challenge. Agusi Amal, I hope I'm saying that correctly, says a bit, quite, very, extremely as well. Very good. And Ramad agrees, and Tan agrees as well. Very good. Well done, everybody. So you are absolutely correct. Number 1 is a bit cold. Number 2 is quite cold. 3 cold. 4 is very cold. And number 5 is extremely cold. Excellent. So these are the modifiers we can use with gradable adjectives like cold. But I have a slightly different question for you now. Can you think of another adjective that means very, very cold? So I don't want you to use cold and a modifier. I want you to think of a completely different word. So you can see at the bottom of your screen down there, there's a number 6 now. So what word could we put at number 6? Can you think of an adjective that means very, very cold? Let us know in the comments, and I'll show some of your answers in just a moment. Okay, welcome if you're just joining us. Today's class is all about gradable and ungradable adjectives. So we're starting to look at gradable adjectives now, and very soon we'll start to look at ungradable adjectives. So what we've learned so far is that the modifiers we can use with gradable adjectives are things like a bit, quite, very, or extremely. There are, of course, lots of other modifiers, but we're just going to focus on these ones for today. Okay, let's have a look. In fact, let's move some of these things off the screen that we don't need. You don't need my name anymore. And let's remove the logo so that you can see the slides properly. Okay, let's have a look at your answers then. So what is the missing word in number 6? Well, lots of you getting the right answer. So Elmo says freezing, and Mamed, I hope I'm saying that correctly, says really extremely. Okay, so you're using multiple modifiers, which grammatically we shouldn't really do, but I get your point. That's good. Then we have Veronica saying freezing cold, and Charlotte saying freezing, and Piero saying freezing as well. Very good. Well done. So freezing is the correct answer here. So this is our first example of what we call an ungradable adjective. So what does that mean? Well, these are adjectives that do not have different levels or different degrees. And they come in two types. There's absolute adjectives. So that would be things like perfect. So this is an absolute adjective because something is either perfect or it's not perfect. There's no middle ground. It's either perfect or it's not. And we also have extreme adjectives like the one we've just learned, which is freezing. So let's now focus in a little bit more on extreme adjectives, shall we? So on the next page, I have this big, big, big long list of adjectives that are gradable. And what I would like to know is what is the extreme version of each of these adjectives? So we've already looked at cold, which we can change to freezing. But how about for the rest of them? So how about number one? What is an extreme version of the adjective hot? So here today in England, and particularly here in this kitchen, oh, it is very, 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 very hot. But I don't want to say very, very, very hot. I want to use one single word to describe how warm it is in here. So there's lots of different answers here. So you're going to see lots of different options for this. But let's have a look at some of your ideas from the comments. So Manvi says, scorching, excellent word, really good word. And that's not one that I actually thought of. So really well done. Yeah, today here in my kitchen, oh, it's scorching. It's scorching. Or we could perhaps say, there was a good answer. Let me grab that. Burning. Okay. Now, burning would mean something slightly different. I'm very glad that my kitchen isn't burning, because if it was burning, it would be on fire. So it's a really good adjective, but it's not got quite the same meaning as hot. But good attempt there, Diana. Well done. Okay, here's the answer that I had written in. Boiling. It's boiling in here. Oh, it's so hot. It's absolutely boiling. So just while you're having a think about number two, let's also think a little bit about pronunciation here. So when you are using these extreme adjectives, we're often exaggerating what we mean. So if you say, oh, it's roasting in here, or it's boiling in here, notice that there's a really, really strong emphasis on the first syllables of those words. It's boiling in here. It's roasting in here. So we're really, really emphasizing the stressed syllable in those words. Okay, let's have a look at number two then. So lots of people coming up with the same word. That's very good. Tiny, and Sarah says tiny as well. Excellent. Very good. Can we think of any others? Oh, there was a good word. Let's see if we can get it. There it is. Petite. Now, petite is a gradable adjective. So small and petite have a similar kind of meaning. But it's an excellent word. It's just not an ungradable word. So well done, Sarush. But yeah, the word that I had thought of for number two was tiny. There's also some other words we could use as well. And yeah, Leticia says tiny as well. Excellent. So some of the other words you could use are minuscule. Minuscule. So notice that I've put two different spellings of this word down below. Now, grammatically speaking, the correct one is with an M-I-N-U. But lots and lots of dictionaries nowadays also have M-I-N-I as the correct spelling too. So it doesn't really matter which one you use. Spelling it with a U is more traditional, and spelling it with an I is more of a modern spelling, but they're both correct. Excellent. Okay, let's move on to number three. What do we think for number three? Ooh, we've got lots of different ones. We've got Morale saying enormous, and Happy saying huge, and Hun saying huge or massive, and Samira saying gigantic. These are all the words that I had thought of as well. So well done, everybody. Let's just make that smaller so we can see everything properly. Okay, so the one I put in my list here was enormous. Again, notice the stress. So that building is enormous. So it's really, really emphasizing that stressed syllable. So in boiling, it's the first syllable. In tiny, it's the first syllable. But in enormous, it's the second syllable. It's enormous. So make sure that you're trying to practice this emphasis at home. So nobody can hear you, and you can practice and make sure that you've got that really strong emphasis on these extreme adjectives. Well done. Some other options I'd also written down were gigantic and huge. Well done. Okay, on to number four then. What about good? What would be a very good alternative to good? Ooh, just one more for the last one as well. Sarah says mammoth. Yes, absolutely. You can describe something as being mammoth. It means very, very big. Well done. Okay, let's have a look. There was one that I wanted to pick up. There it is. Excellent. Absolutely excellent, Bahar. Well done. So yes, excellent is an extreme version of good. Great, says Minnie. Now, great, absolutely, yes. So that would also be ungradable. Well done. We also had, oh, just one more for number three as well. We had Renu saying colossal. Colossal is a really good word. So yes, that one means very, very big. Good job. Okay, let's just get one more. Awesome. Yeah, it's absolutely awesome. So awesome is a very, very common word that you'll hear in American English. We do say it in British English too, but it's very common in American English. The word I went for was amazing, but all of your options were really good too. So let's have a look at some other options. Fantastic. The film I saw was fantastic and brilliant as well. So these are all good alternatives for ungradable versions of good. Well done. Okay, number five, bad. How can we change bad into an extreme adjective? Just while you're thinking, a few more from you guys. Unbelievable. Yeah, that's a really good word. Using the same example as before, I went to see a film and it was unbelievable. It was really, really good. Well done. Okay, we have Erkan saying awful for number five. Very good. And we have TCI Sue saying terrible for number five. Again, another excellent word. Oh, there was a nice word. Let me see if I can just scroll back up and find it. Lena says atrocious. Excellent. Yes, another really good ungradable adjective. So in my list, I went with awful. And then there were also these words as well. Oh, it was terrible. It was horrible. And again, notice that I'm really, really emphasizing the stressed syllable in those words because we are exaggerating. Okay, great. On to number six, scary. Scary. What word can we use for number six? An ungradable adjective for number six. Let's go with that one first. Sarah says horrifying. Yes, something can be horrifying. Absolutely, really, really scary. So it was. I saw a horror film and it was horrifying. Very good. Roselda says terrifying. Excellent. Going back to number five for a second, Marip said dreadful. Yes, absolutely dreadful. That's a good word for number five. Well done. Oh, let's choose that one next. So Malak says frightening for number six. So frightening is only a gradable adjective. So you would say it's a bit frightening, it's quite frightening, it's very frightening, it's extremely frightening. But we wouldn't use it as an ungradable one there. But it's another really good word. So well done, Malak. Petrifying. Very good, Fatima. sorry if I'm saying that incorrectly. So petrifying, yes, that means you're really scared, really scared. Well done. Okay, I went with terrifying for our list, and I've also put down, oh no, I didn't put any extras down for that one, but all of the options you gave me were really good, so well done. Okay, on to number 7, happy. What's an extreme form of happy? What do we think? Let's have a look. So Sai says cheerful. So that one would be a gradable adjective. So again, we can use things like very cheerful or extremely cheerful, but not absolutely cheerful. Joyful would be the same thing there, Olivier. So joyful, I'm very joyful, for example. Let's see. We've got, everything's moving so quickly. Let's have a look. Delighted. I am absolutely delighted to meet you, Waleed. Yes, excellent. Delighted would be a really good ungradable adjective there. Well done. Glad. Glad is a gradable. So again, we would say I'm very glad, I'm extremely glad, and things like that. Okay, I went with ecstatic for number 7. So if you are exceptionally happy, you would say, oh, I'm ecstatic today. I'm having a really good day. Some other options that you might want to use instead are things like over the moon and elated. So over the moon is an English idiom. It just means very, very happy. So maybe somebody tells you that they've got a new job and you say, oh, I'm over the moon for you. I'm over the moon for you. I'm very happy that you got your new job. Excellent. Okay, on to number 8 then, sad. So what's an extreme version of sad? What do we think? So Juan went with gloomy. Now gloomy is a gradable adjective. So again, things like a bit gloomy, very gloomy, extremely gloomy, but it's an excellent word, well done. There's another really nice idiom for number 7. So Bektas says on cloud 9. So if you are on cloud 9, you're very, very happy. We can't really use a modifier with this expression. You can't say I'm absolutely on cloud 9. It sounds a little bit strange, but it's a really, really good ungradable adjective. Well done. Okay, let's go with that one. Roselda says for number 8, miserable. I'm absolutely miserable. Yes, really well done. Very good job. And that's exactly the word that I went for too. So good job. Let's have a look at a few others. Christine said down. So I'm very down today, or I'm absolutely down. So yes, down would be an ungradable adjective. Very good job. Well done. Sorrowful, says La. So I'm very sorrowful. I'm absolutely sorrowful. I'm quite sorry. So sorrowful would be more of a gradable adjective there. So things like a bit, quite, very, and extremely. Excellent. Shall we move on to number 9? What do you have for number 9? Well, there was one excellent word that just went off my screen. There we go. Gemini says gorgeous. Yes, excellent word. So gorgeous fits very well for number 9. Pretty is the gradable form and gorgeous is the extreme form. So you're absolutely gorgeous. Very good. And we have Bektas saying cute for number 9. Cute is a gradable, so something can be very cute or extremely cute. And let's have a look at, there's a nice word, flawless. I'm sorry I can't read your name because I can't read the character, but that's a really good word to describe how someone or something looks. It's flawless. Very good. Okay, I went with beautiful, just the normal adjective. So you can say that something is absolutely beautiful. Some other options that you could use there would be stunning or breathtaking. So you can use these to describe how someone else looks, maybe your boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, or wife, for example, or it could be used to describe the things that you can see. So imagine you go to the top of a building and you look out and, the view is breathtaking. The view is absolutely breathtaking. Okay, good job. Number 10. What do we have for number 10? Let's see. Ooh, just a few others. Exquisite. Exquisite is a really good word, Sarah. Well done. It's absolutely exquisite. But for number 10, Risky says hideous. And that's the one that I went with too, Risky. Well done. Great minds think alike. Okay, well done. We also have horrible from Lorena. So it's absolutely horrible. Yes, we can use horrible to describe the way that something looks. Well done. And grisly. It's absolutely grisly or very grisly. That's a tough one. It's a bit grisly. So I would say that's more of a gradable adjective, Mohammed, but it's a really good word. So again, well done. Some other options. Did I have other options? No, I didn't. So number 11, hungry. What's the extreme form of hungry? And, oh, sorry, misclicked there. Oh, misclicked again. There we go. Hyun, I got you. Number 11 is starving. And that's exactly what I went with too. There is one other word that I had written down, which is, if it will, there, oh, there we go. Ravenous. Oh, I'm ravenous. And I am ravenous. I've not had my lunch yet. So I am definitely going to be eating very soon. Okay, good job, guys. So hopefully you've learned a couple of new adjectives whilst we've been going through this list. So that rather than saying, that film is very good, which is quite basic level English, you can now use some different ones. Oh, it was amazing. It was fantastic. Or how you're feeling. So, oh, I'm ecstatic today. I've had a really good day. But the next thing we need to do is focus more in on modifiers. Okay, so let's get rid of that and let's have a look at this. So we've already looked at the gradable modifiers. We can use a bit, quite, very, and extremely with gradable adjectives. But for ungradable adjectives, although they don't have different levels, we can modify those adjectives. Now, the main one and the most important one to know is absolutely. Absolutely almost always works. But we can also sometimes use totally and completely to modify those extreme or absolute adjectives. And one final thing, really can be used for both. So we can say something is really cold or it's really freezing today. Both would be okay. Excellent. So we are coming towards the end of the class and we've still got lots of practice to do. So let's move on to the final stage of today's class. I'm going to kind of tell you a story about my imaginary holiday and you're going to complete it with the correct modifiers. So let's make that big screen. Practice time. I went on holiday to Greece. It was lovely to get away and relax. I went on holiday to Greece. It was lovely to get away and relax. So lovely, is that a gradable or ungradable adjective? And which one of those options do we use then? Is it going to be A, absolutely lovely, or B, very lovely? So let's see what you all think. So Rumi says A, absolutely, and Smart disagrees and says very, and Status says very as well, and Bettina says A as well. So let's see, shall we? Oh, I can't click off the comment. Let's go B for Status, and absolutely is the correct answer here. So lovely is an extreme adjective. It can't be graded. There's not different levels of loveliness. It is lovely or it's not. So it's absolutely lovely to get away and relax. Okay, on with the story. However, the hotel was cheap, so it wasn't very nice. So this time we're looking at the adjective cheap. So is cheap gradable or ungradable? And then which of those modifiers do we use to complete the sentence? Is it a bit cheap or totally cheap? Let's see what you all think. So Ganesh says a bit, and Amjad says totally. Ruby says it's A, a bit, and Juan says it's B, and Tan says A. Okay, shall we have a look? This one is A. Okay, the hotel was a bit cheap, so it wasn't very nice. So cheap is a gradable adjective, so we have to use this gradable modifier a bit. Okay, on to the next part of my holiday. We spent our first day at the beach. It was, roasting, so we used lots of sun cream. It was, roasting, so we used lots of sun cream. So we've already looked at the word roasting today. So can you remember, is it gradable or ungradable? And then which one of these do we use? Let's have a look. So Chris says that it's B absolutely. Tan says it's B absolutely. And this user, sorry, I can't read your name, but you also agree that it's B. And then we have Born to be Free, who thinks it's A, very. And Nui, who says B. And Pamela says absolutely. Absolutely, it is absolutely. Okay, so roasting is an ungradable adjective, so we must use something like absolutely roasting. Okay, next day of my holiday. We visited a few museums which were fascinating. So this is a new adjective. We didn't speak about fascinating earlier. So fascinating just means very, very interesting. And that should give you a clue which of these modifiers we use to complete the sentence. So if fascinating means very, very, very interesting, it's an extreme adjective. So do we use A totally or B extremely? Let's have a look at your options. So I apologize, I can't read your name, but you think that it's extremely fascinating. And Olivier says totally fascinating. So we've got different answers there. And we have Juan, who says A, totally fascinating. And Youssef, who says absolutely. So in a way, you are correct there. Well done. So Yuto says B. Totally is more appropriate here because fascinating is an ungradable adjective. Now, this is where this topic can be a little bit confusing because you will hear people say it was extremely fascinating. Grammatically speaking, we should use totally because fascinating is an extreme adjective. It already means very, very interesting. Okay, next part. The following day, we went skydiving. I was frightened, but then I wanted to go again. So how about frightened? Can you remember from earlier, is frightened gradable or ungradable? And then do we use completely or do we use a bit for this question? Let's see what you think. So Benita says a bit frightened, and Burema, I hope I'm saying that correctly, says completely frightened. And Ganesh says a bit frightened. And Nora, oh, sorry, I couldn't click on it quick enough. Sorry, Nora. Uzma says B. Samira says B. And Fika says a bit. And Samira says B. Oh, I keep on trying to click off and I can't. There we go. Excellent. Okay, a bit is the correct answer here. So frightened is a gradable adjective. You can be a bit frightened, quite frightened, very frightened, or extremely frightened. So a bit is the correct one for this example. That evening, we went to a beautiful restaurant. The food was, delicious. So is it very delicious or really delicious? What do you think? So we didn't speak about delicious before, but hopefully you're all familiar with this extreme adjective for describing food. So we could say it was tasty, which is the gradable version, or we can say, it was delicious. But would we say it's very delicious or really delicious? What do you think? Let's have a look. So this user says really, and Lena also says really as well. Renu says really, and Marip says really, and Roselda says really. And I think I'm sensing a theme here, so well done, very good. The food was really delicious. So remember that you can use really with both gradable and ungradable adjectives. So you could say it's really tasty the gradable form, or you can say it was really delicious, the ungradable form. Well done. On our last day, we went on a trip down the coast. The views were stunning. So we spoke about stunning earlier. So this is an extreme adjective. So which one of these words can we use with extreme adjectives? Let's have a look. So Erkan says people who knows this. This user says extremely stunning. And Juan says totally stunning. And Yuki says totally stunning. And Gia says that it's extremely stunning. So again, we've got a mixed bag of answers, and TC Aisu says totally stunning. So the correct answer for this one is totally. The views were totally stunning. And that's because we use totally with ungradable adjectives, and stunning is ungradable. Okay, guys, final question for the day. Unfortunately, when we were traveling back, the airport lost our bags. It was a bad way to end a really great holiday. So bad, is bad gradable or ungradable? And do we use completely or very? Is it, it was a completely bad way or a very bad way? What do you think? Let's see. So Huang says B, and Hung says B, and Elena says A, and Hoa says B, and Kuldeep says very. Very is the correct answer here. So bad is gradable. It can be a bit bad, quite bad, very bad, extremely bad. Okay, well done, everybody. So that is the end of the class for today. So I just want to leave you on this page here. So there are many other modifiers that we can use in English, but these are the more important ones. These are the most common ones, okay? So thank you all ever so much for joining today. It's been a pleasure to teach you all. Just before I go, I'd just like to remind you that we do have a very useful worksheet for you guys to download from the website. So if you are interested in doing a little bit more practice of these gradable and ungradable adjectives, in fact, let's get rid of all that. If you are interested in doing more practice of these gradable and ungradable adjectives, go over to the website and you can download a free worksheet so you can get a little bit more practice. And if you have only joined halfway through, as Ashraf did, don't worry, you can watch the whole video again. We'll be putting it onto Facebook and it will stay on YouTube forever and ever and ever. So you can watch the class back and participate in it. But that's all from me for today. So I'd just like to give you a great big thank you and have a lovely day wherever you are in the world. And we will see you all again soon. Okay, take care, everybody. Bye-bye.